into our fourth match of the day here at the Kumamoto Masters Japan. Semi-final day here on court one. And it's the mixed doubles now. Feng Yangzhe, Huang Dongping, third seeds from China, take on Japan's Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino. They are the second seeds here. And here we are, then, looking at the bracket. The winner of this match, the winners will play Zheng Siwei and Huang Yachong in the final, the number one seeds. It's nice to see the top four seeds in the semi-finals as well. Can Watanabe Higashino give the home fans something to cheer about? It's the first time we are seeing Japanese representation today. So there'll be a good reception for sure. There you go. Especially this being the very first Kumamoto Masters Japan. That is what, from a neutral point of view, you'd want to have. I'm sure that's what the home supporters want to see as well. Look at Feng Yangzhe, he's towering over everyone else. You'll get a closer look of it now when they do the toss. There you go. Just waiting for Watanabe. They've met twice before. Watanabe and Higashino have won all of them. Most recently in Asian Games last month.
Kumamoto toss. Red. Black. Who lost?
Black.
Black. On the toss. Who will receive? Arisa receive. You think? Okay, Huang has.
It's a toss won by the Japanese. No real rush for him to get under the court. Finally, Feng Yangzhe, 22 years of age, is a whopping 195 centimeters tall from the north of the country in Tianjin, playing in his highest ever ranking. Asian Games, they got a bronze medal. Huang Dongping, 28, the senior partner of the two. She's from the south of the country, Fujian. 165 centimeters tall, and together, they've only been together for a very short time. They've already won seven titles together. They dropped a game against Yamashita and Shinoya, perhaps surprising. In fact, they were at one point looking like they might be bundled out, but then they stormed back in the third, didn't they? This year alone, well, they've won all seven titles this year, I should say, as well. Runner-up just once in the Malaysia Masters, but they won Indonesia Masters, Thailand Masters, German Open, Korea Open, Australian Open, Arctic Open, and the Denmark Open. Yuta Watanabe is 26, just 167 is old. It's about 30 centimeter difference between him and Feng. He's from the capital, Tokyo, and of course they are a former world number one pairing. That was from about a year ago. Arisa Higashino is from the north of the country, Hokkaido, 160 centimeters tall. They got the bronze at the their home Olympics in Tokyo, World Championships. They finished second twice in 21 and 22, third twice 2019 and 2023. Asian Games as well, they got a silver. Guess who they lost to? Tan Kianming and Lai Peijing, they were very, very good against. Asian Championships, they finished third last year and they won it in 2019. Ajendra Rai from India, our umpire. And Ravida from Thailand, our service judge. They've won 10 titles together. Watanabe and Higashino. They won the Japan Open this year to the delight, I'm sure, of the home fans. They'd love to do the double. They also won the India Open this year. A few runners-up places at the Malaysia Open, Singapore Open and Indonesia Open. So a relatively decent year in 2023. This is a tight one, isn't it, Chris?
Yeah, I mean, you've got two and three in the world playing each other. Yeah. I think the strange thing is head-to-head, both of them for the Japanese, but always close. And both pairs, you know, if I had to guess, could the home crowd make a difference? Mm. I don't know. I mean, it's pretty full in here.
It is.
Ladies and gentlemen.
90% full.
On my right, Arisa Higashino and Yuta Watanabe, Japan. And on my left, Huang Dongping and Feng Yanzi, China. Huang Dongping to Seoul to Arisa Higashino. Level play.
Huang Dongping is the mixed doubles Olympic champion at the moment. And that was with a previous
one
partner.
One
new. Over the sort of the breakup, the punch of the Huang Yiliu, hasn't she? Huang Dongping hasn't lost a stride. I mean, seven titles in one year.
Now she's just a very, very, very good player. I think she could almost play with anyone. There's not many mixed doubles partnerships where I'd say the male player would be very, very confident to lift cross to put his, it's not put her in trouble, but, you know, put the female player on the straight. But I'd say Huang Dongping's defense is so good that it's on par, if not possibly better than her partner's.
Great reactions there.
Again, you know, I can't see it changing. We're going to be having these long, hard-fought rallies. The fences on court are so good that we're not going to have many big, cheap points.
That is our longest rally so far in this early stages, 39 shots.
Thank you.
massive ready, and then as soon as he gets half a chance here, bang, and then great placement where the big gap was. When he gets the half chance, can generate so much power.
Just trading points at the moment. No one yet able to score consecutive points.
Good serve. Too bad. I think he was just too slow to move across and cover his side. Yuta got back really well. He's so agile. But there, he's not, you can see, he hasn't covered his line enough. He's lingered. He sort of stayed in the middle for too long. Working the rally, and in the end, great placement. You can see there, it's so difficult because it's so flat. Incredible control, and then gets up and hits his like a trademark. His stop drop is so good. It's so deceptive and hard to see, hard to read.
Keep it going. Probably shouldn't have asked that question. Comes to an end.
Incredibly well to get themselves out of trouble. It all stems from the start of the rally. Slightly loose return and good pressure from the Chinese. This is why the first three or shots and doubles are so integral because everything stems from the beginning of the rally.
You know, earlier you and I were talking about Siosun Jae and how hard it is to juggle both men's and mixed. I mean, and then whether he might eventually have to make a choice. This man here, Yuta Watanabe, did that, didn't he?
He did, you know. And I totally get it. I totally get why he made the choice. And I think it was the right choice, but I'd love to see him play in men's doubles again. Yeah, he was, you know.
Was it a joy to watch?
Not to play against, but right. Yeah, to watch he was. When he played Avendo, their defense was so good. I think they were the best defenders in the world at the time. Great attack. Gone all the way across. Higashino.
We talked about how hard it is to get down for him, but boy, when he gets up there, that's coming at quite a height, isn't it?
Yeah. Yuta shot there, slightly clear, partner in trouble, but incredible placement on the attack. That's the advantage he does have being tall. He can hit that, the big smash, and also the angle. The placement, the hold, and then just almost a last-second punch.
They've battled hard, haven't they, so far? Only a point between them.
Feng moved the shuttle around so well.
So at the break, Feng and Huang now in front. They have an 11-9 lead. Yeah, that's Watanabe and Higashino.
Watanabe. Yeah, great work in the net, Higashino, and then brilliant follow-up. Watanabe, yeah, good interception, and then brilliant. Read it so well, Watanabe. Gets it on the replay, it's the placement that does it. Huang Dongping does the right thing, she moves across to cover the gap. And then Yuta ends up putting it down the middle of the court.
Good start for them since the interval. Semi-finals. They've won 10 out of 13, including their last three. The last time they lost in a semi-final was actually also in Japan. Japan Open. They lost to Quabranico and Teratanachai.
Players, they're making defending look easy, but defending is so difficult because it's not just getting the shuttle back, it's getting the shuttle back but putting it into a gap to try and relieve the stress that you're under, and that's what everyone is doing so well on court.
Huang Dongping and Feng Yangtze have never lost to Chinese pair in, a Japanese pair in semi-finals. They've won all three before. Matches against Japanese pairs overall.
It's a good angle on that attack from Yuta. He might not be the tallest of players, but he jumps so high that he manages to get a pretty good angle.
Higashino leading by two here. They've got about almost a 50-50 record in semi-finals. They've won 22 out of 40 of them. Well, they've lost their last two. The last win was at the Japan Open, in fact. I guess Dung Sa Wen, Huang Yachao. Well, that's easy for Feng.
14-15.
Good drive and then just good pressure, and it's so hard for the Japanese to go that way.
It's interesting with the Japanese pair playing against the Chinese in semi-finals. They've only ever won 5 out of 20. Though, 3 of those 5 wins have come in the last 4 matches. Perhaps starting to get to grips with it. All 3 were, by the way, against Dung Sa Wei and Huang Yachong. So well there, didn't she? Higashino.
She did, because Feng actually set herself up. Hit the hard smash there, and then she did so well. Incredible defense from Higashino.
3 wins and 58 matches against Chinese opposition, Japanese. Looking good here. Oh, the stop drop again, comes to the ball. Played immaculately.
Yeah, I mean, he played two, but the speed he moves at as well, there. And that, and he's moving at full speed and he's off balance. And
he's,
yeah, you know, it's his trademark shot. He plays it so, so well.
Do you think if he did a masterclass in stop drop, you'd just have everyone signing
yeah,
off?
Yeah, I think I'd go. You know, I think everyone would. He is so good. It's such a deceptive shot. But I think it's something he's had to do just because his power's good, but it's not exceptional. So he's found another solution, which is to, you know, work upon that stop drop to make it, you know, absolutely unbelievable.
Don't delay the game.
Umpire telling Huang Dongping to get on with things.
Again, and Feng just can't allow the shuttle to go in an upward direction to him, and it's that shot there, and it allows him to put the pressure on. And that first drive that Feng hits, great drive, because it's going downwards, which allows him to then step forward. String went.
17.
Well, they've drawn level here, the Chinese. Oh, that's played late. And so he quickly takes advantage of it, Watanabe.
That's the thing, Yuta, he's always active, he's always ready here, watching, waiting, seeing, and then he steps in, look at that.
Yeah. He anticipates, you said like yesterday.
And this is the key, and that's something he does so well. He's always anticipating where to move to, what to cover.
They move too clear here. Watanabe Higashino. Let's cut that back.
To even get a racket on this one, even get a racket on it was incredible.
To be able to just shift like that, impressive.
Because he's there early, the stress, the pressure that you feel is enough for him to then be able to just hold it and stop it off. There. And he was so good at the net when he played men's doubles.
Two game points for Watanabe Higashino. Again, sublime shot from Watanabe. A top quality first game here for both sides. But it's the Japanese who edge proceedings.
Just look at this winner.
You could just watch that kind of thing all day, couldn't you?
That's the thing, it's not that he just steps, he obviously steps in incredibly well, anticipates it, but then his shot selection and also the quality of the shot.
21-18, they take the first game.
Second game, love all, play.
Want to continue where they left off here, the Japanese.
One.
shot by Yu today. Just opens up his body to make it even more deceptive, and then just pushes the shuttle into the gap. Here you can see, just opens up. Looks like he's going to play it cross, and just feeds it down the line into where the space is. Easy, and that's against one of the biggest hitters in the world.
Here for the Japanese. Just remember that Seo Sung-jae and Choi Yu-jung won that first game against Huang Ya-chong and Deng Tze-wei, and then had an 8-1 lead in the second. Went on to lose it. And then the match.
Oh, wow. That was incredibly sharp. He covers. Brilliant. The important thing there, as soon as she played her return, she's up, she's bigger than that. To look for the next one. She hasn't just ducked and let her partner cover.
Still. Well, that's well short, isn't it? That takes the pressure right off. When you have a serve like that, you think when you're in a good moment?
Yeah, I mean, you never want the run to end.
It's a gift, isn't it?
It's a slightly cheap point, yeah.
Anticipating a stop drop, and
well, I mean, this is what makes his attack, as in his smash, more dangerous. The placement there's the key. He's hit the right hip, which is such a difficult place to defend from. But just in that rally, just watch user only, and the amount he moves, even when he's not hitting the shuttle, he's everywhere. Great return. He's saying there, has he not moved before I've served?
4-6.
To be fair, I don't think he did. He's just a tall guy that's reached forward.
Yeah, he's right up there, isn't he, Feng Yongte, with the very tallest.
Chases off. Yuta is storming in. So he's got the net covered and he's on it early. And the way they work around each other, they work together as a pair, it is incredible.
Oh. Higashino knows. So, who's he want to give away?
Track the record down rather than forward. But the net, you have no time at all to make the decision.
Six, seven.
Good work from
Wang Dongping just covering, pushing past the net player, just deep enough but not too hard. And it was the first shot, was just a good push, and then she's ready on the next one. It makes it easier to be able to put it away.
Of this match, take on Wang Yachong and Deng Zhiwei in the final tomorrow.
Tall player. Side, making his opponents move the full distance, the full width of the court.
So at the interval then, it's a 1-point lead for Watanabe and Higashino. Not too different from what we saw at the interval of the first game, which they won. Yeah, yesterday we were talking about instructions being given across. There's Jeremy Gunn there from Malaysia. He's been there for 5 years now almost with Watanabe Higashino. And he's helped really propel them, hasn't he? They were 29th in the world when he took over. And they've worked so well together.
Yeah, I mean, he's got a proven track record of assisting with mixed doubles And since going to Japan, if you look now, Japan have quite a few mixed doubles players that are the younger generation now that are coming through. You've obviously got the pair on court that we're looking at of Yuta and Arisa, but they also have some other pairs coming through, which they haven't had for a period of time. They've only ever normally had one pair, or it's been an event that they hadn't done quite as well in the past. Chinese, they did, the Japanese did so well to stay in the rally because look at this just relentless pressure. But something that I really think Japan are doing so well is almost every match where there's a Japanese pair on throughout this tournament, we've had an experienced coach then with a very, very, very high level player in the past. On this court, we've got Hayakawa behind the court, and he was a fantastic men's doubles player, but also mixed doubles player.
Seen by a Korean, Park Ju-bong.
Yeah, Park Ju-bong's done that. He's done incredible since he went to Japan.
16 years, and look at what he's done.
Yeah, and the amount they've improved. Before they went, to kind of put it into perspective, I would go as far as to say a country like England were a better nation than Japan.
Wow.
And if you look now how that has changed, you know, Japan are one of the very, very, very best nations in the world.
Wow, what a turnaround.
A lot of that has to be down to Park Ju-bong. Himself being one of the best players ever.
Feng and Huang have taken a 3-point lead here. It's been a good post-interval session for them so far. To arrest that run that the Chinese were going through. That's four in a row.
Stemming how wide they made Wang Dongping have to move, and then she was in trouble. Chinese just seeing that Yuta was off balance, and then he was almost going in slightly the wrong direction, just putting the shuttle into the gap just on that one. Great vision from Huang Dongping.
why, as far as the Japanese are concerned, to stop the advance of the Chinese.
The way the Japanese attack, they attack, it's so organized. They cover each other so well. As soon as they have to swap and Arisa has to rotate off, Yuta's so quick to chase forward and cover the net.
Been some trouble, the Japanese, and I thought they turned it around.
Yeah, I think, I mean, let's have a look 14. At this replay. I think she's got it. Yeah, swing's too big.
Yeah, she was in trouble there, Higashino.
18, 14.
And the Chinese are looking good here. Four-point lead. That's a good time.
Play.
Attack. When anyone hits steep, it's so hard to do much with it because it's coming at your knees or below. So any shot you have to hit defensively, it's got to go in such an upward direction.
Nicely done. Is there still hope here for the Japanese?
Feng after that, he's hit the shuttle where he should have hit the shot. Every time at the moment, Arisa's playing straight return, she's just covering the line, he's got to turn it to the other side.
Awkward shot there for Watanabe. And there's five game points here for the Chinese pair. Something I think technical issue.
The white person.
Oh, it's maybe something just a light, maybe. Something that's just distracting the Japanese. Just distracting the something actually just to the right of us.
It's just the angle of one of the lights, maybe it was just catching Yuta's eye.
So we are going to go into this third then. Fairly convincing from Feng and Huang. They take it. So let's see how this third one pans out. It's one apiece. Oh, wow. Winning the second, just getting in each other's way. One, on. Jungter.
Keep the shuttle going down. And then the chance gets easier and easier because it's so hard for Han Dongping to get the shuttle away. For the Japanese because they can't just lift to him because he's so dangerous on the attack. Yuta there has just tried to move the shuttle around.
That's the force at which it comes from Feng.
And that's why they can't just lift, but it was that shot there, fantastic from the cross-court block, which meant Yuta was so low that he had to lift. He didn't really have much choice.
Margins. Today that have gone to three has seen two very tight first games and then the third very one-sided. This one sort of has a different feel to it at the moment.
Solution to that, just going over. You can't just
the lip wasn't deep enough as well. He's got to try and go in front or go over Arisa rather than Yuta. To set up a partner, taking the pace off, so it was so low he had to lift. Pressure, you can't turn the shuttle away.
Tips of that, still alive.
Absolutely unbelievable defence. I think the rally should have ended three times there. Yeah. Somehow the Japanese found a way. Incredible. Absolutely incredible defence from both of them.
Points down, it is 8-all. Very tight this. And they're on a bit of a roll here at the moment. But this a third tight game, this is where that's where this crowd can make the difference, can't it?
Yeah, definitely. Just increase the pressure on the Chinese by the crowd getting louder and louder.
Good points for the Japanese. The best run of this second game. Can they go to the interval with an even bigger lead? This
stop drop. Doesn't work out. But Watanabe. This one. Monumental rally, which ends in disappointment for the home crowd. 108 shots.
Yeah, monster rally, monster rally. The discipline showing from all four players there, really impressive. Everyone defending so well.
So close this. Chinese who take that very, very slender 1-point lead into the interval. 11-10 here in game three.
Okay,
11, 10, play.
There's some treatment required. Feng Yangte. He's got a nosebleed, is he?
Yeah, it looks like all of a sudden he's got a nosebleed.
Well, he's at high altitude himself, isn't he? At just a few meters tall. Keep your head up, I think, Huang Dongping. It's always a bit of a concern when there's no contact and you suddenly get a nosebleed, isn't it?
Yeah, I'd say it's quite surprising.
No sort of contact that I can recall. Is there a moment of concern here, perhaps? This game is so delicately poised as well, this third game. Don't want to have that something jammed up your nose as well, ideally. Not the most comfortable thing, I can tell you. But he's going to have to do that to stem the bleeding. You ever had that, Chris? Nose bleeding?
Never during a match, no.
Okay, well, he's decided not to have it. Couple of stoppages today. We saw one for Tunja earlier. She went on to win her match against Bo and Zhang. Ping with a former partner, Wang Yu, against Watanabe and Higashino. It's a whopping 11-3 in Huang Dongping and Wang Yu's favour.
Did he get that?
Wow. He made it. In the end, the Japanese win the point anyway. There you go. Kind of lost his footing as well as he played that. Japanese. Now they're in front again. Snatching at that one. Higashino maybe.
Just slightly, your edge gets snatched. It's so important at the net. You just almost want to punch it rather than snatch. You don't want too big a backswing. You don't want too big a follow through. You've got to take the shuttle in front of you. Judgment from Utah. A little bit of a gift there. Boom. Shot in that rally. Sure, we're going to get seeing it from Higashino. She held the shuttle and just went back over Huang Dongping, which instantly got them the attack. Because that's exactly where the gap was.
Closer than maybe many would have thought, but it is out. Up by two. How crucial will that be in the final reckoning?
Utah just served. Seen the umpires.
Confused?
Yeah, I think he's just lost track a little bit because Utah just served short, obviously, at 15 on the odd side, and now he's just serving and returning, which obviously it can't happen. On his forehand, Huang Dongping fractionally served across him, which made it a bit more difficult for him to play that shot that he wanted to play.
All square again. It's
serve from Huang Dongping.
Yeah, Huang Dongping reads this so well. And then steps off, covers the line. And can put the pressure on the Japanese. In. He's taken that shot so early. The placement's brilliant. You can see Huang Dongping just apologising to her partner. She was just too low to be able to play the shot that she tried to play. Build-up play from Feng, controlling the rally, and then what a way to finish the rally. Brilliant shot, great vision from Huang Dongping to see where the gap was.
It really is a seesaw battle, this one.
Move, stepped in, and the last shot he's played, incredible skill level to play that tight. He's so good at finding the gaps. Yeah, stretches opponents.
Just possibly a puff hand a little bit there, Huang Dongping. Still looking at it.
Into that awkward spot. Probably not Higashino, I think Yuta was there to cover.
Sets up two match points. Feng and Huang here on the break, perhaps. Once the match, this is the longest one of the day so far.
those attacks. Still one to go, though, for Watanabe and Higashino.
Too good a shot when it serves too good. You've got to calmly play out the full rally.
Yeah.
You don't want to force it, you don't want to try anything too good too early.
Maybe the more inexperienced of the two.
Now all of a sudden, from having too much points to a match point down.
This place will go. Not yet. Well, someone's riding on it. Short serve there from Watanabe. Back to needing a winner by two clear points. The second match point. We've seen a battle of forced errors all of a sudden in these last few points, haven't we?
Yeah, and this is the thing, everyone gets more tense, you know. You can't help it. It's the very end of a really long match, 88 minutes long. Everyone's getting tired physically, mentally, just getting a bit nervy. Oh, that looked close. Ooh. Great judgment, though. Frank Dong picking to leave that.
Wow. All four of them have created errors.
Now, how many more twists and turns are we going to see before the match ends?
Two match points apiece. Pin drop silence in here.
This is why it's so integral at the end of a match. You have to, or you want to, try to get the attack, just because when everyone's that little bit edgier, that little bit more tense, is so much harder to control the shuttle around the court. We saw there from Watanabe, he defended so well throughout the match. He just snapped for that last one, just because he is a little bit more tense, everyone is.
Third match point now for Feng and Huang. Another final, looking for their eighth title of 2023. What a match we've just had, though.
Yeah, it was sad anyone had to not win that game. What a match it was.
Monster match between these two pairs. It could barely be separated. Two match points for Watanabe and Higashino. They couldn't convert. Having taken that first game, they battled back Feng and Huang in the second. Won that relatively comfortably, and it was a very, very tight third. Fantastic entertainment for the crowd. It hasn't ended the way they would have wanted. Feng Yangte and Huang Dongping. Now looking forward to a final against another fantastic Chinese pair of Dongte Wei and Huang Yaqiong. All China mixed doubles final. So Feng Yangte, Huang Dongping, the third seeds from China, beat the second seeds from Japan. Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino. 18-21, 21-15, 24-22. They've done it in 91 minutes. Coming up next, we have got the first men's singles semi-final. Xu Ji, the fourth seed from China, takes on Chinese Taipei's Zhou Tianchen.
Welcome back to Kumamoto on semi-final Saturday here at the Kumamoto Masters. And what two thrilling mixed doubles semi-finals we've had. Up next is the first of the men's singles semi-finals, and it is Xu Yuqi against Zhou Tianchen of Chinese Taipei. It's a battle between the